The definition of a whitewash is to deliberately attempt to conceal unpleasant or incriminating facts about someone or something. Liz Cambage famously accused the Australian Olympic Committee of whitewashing the team publicity photo. It's ironic that Cambage has now benefited from a whitewash investigation by Basketball Australia into her altercation with the Nigerian team prior to the Olympic Games. In a classic news dump, Basketball Australia released the following statement at 5 p.m. on Friday, the 5th of November, 2021. An investigation was conducted into an incident that occurred during a scrimmage between the Opals and Nigeria on the 13th of July, 2021 in Las Vegas, involving Elizabeth Cambage. Following the investigation, the matter was referred to an independent hearing panel to determine whether, under the National Framework for Ethical Behavior and Integrity in Basketball, Elizabeth Cambage engaged in prohibited conduct. The independent hearing was held on the 29th of October, 2021. The panel, after examination of the evidence before it, determined that Elizabeth Cambage did engage in conduct that brought Basketball Australia into a censure in relation to one of the incidents charged. Charges in relation to the other three alleged incidents were dismissed. The independent hearing panel have issued her with a formal reprimand. Let's review the incident and Basketball Australia's response. In July 2021, the Opals played the Nigerian basketball team in a scrimmage in preparation for the Olympic Games. During the scrimmage, Cambage was reportedly involved in a physical altercation, as well as a heated verbal exchange with some of the Nigerian players. Following the incident, rumors soon circulated about Cambage's Opal teammates being unhappy with her behavior and her breaking COVID-19 protocols. Cambage then announced that she was withdrawing from the Opals due to her mental health and denied that she had broken any COVID protocols, calling this fake news. Cambage then later downplayed the incident with the Nigerian team on her social media account, saying things got heated in the Nigerian game and there were words exchanged. At the time, Basketball Australia issued the following statement. The circumstances surrounding the incident that occurred during the scrimmage between Nigeria and Australia involving Liz Cambage are currently under investigation for a breach of the Integrity Framework and Code of Conduct, BA said in a statement. Basketball Australia went on to advise that it wouldn't comment on the investigation until it's over, given Cambage's withdrawal from the game's team due to mental health reasons. Basketball Australia announced that its Integrity Division would run the investigation. After Basketball Australia's recent statement following the investigation, many are asking, what did the investigation find? The answer is, we don't know. What did Cambage say to the Nigerian team? The answer is, we don't know. Andrew Bogut is the only person to offer any potential glimpse into what might have been said by Cambage during a radio interview with Joel Kane. From what you're hearing, without saying exactly what you've heard or what's doing the grapevine, is it a racial thing? Is it a derogatory thing? Bogut replied, all of the above. From what I've heard, it's all of the above. It's not good, and it's not words you want to utter, and that's why it can't be repeated on the radio. It's just not good. There are words that are sometimes said in the heat of battle, and they are definitely not on that list. They should not be excused, mental health or not. The lack of public accountability by Cambage and Basketball Australia regarding what she said is striking when compared to an incident which took place during the 2021 WNBA season when Cambage complained publicly about the language used by WNBA coach Kurt Miller. Cambage let rip at Miller on social media after taking offense to a comment he made to refs about her weight when complaining about a foul. Cambage was left fuming after the incident, and she spoke about the incident on her Instagram. Miller released a statement to say he was sorry the following morning. The WNBA suspended Miller and fined him $10,000. Cambage's alleged behavior in the Nigerian scrimmage and her subsequent withdrawal from the Opals has been polarizing. Some felt she was using her mental health as a shield to excuse her poor behavior. Others felt Cambage needed to be better supported, as she unfairly receives more criticism than other athletes, as she's willing to speak out on controversial issues, such as the lack of diversity in the Australian Olympic photo. To fairly assess whether the penalty fits the crime, and in this case the allegations against Cambage, one needs to understand what the allegations are. In this instance, the details put forward to the hearing have not been disclosed by Basketball Australia. In fact, considering the investigation more broadly, there's been a distinct lack of detail provided by the sport's governing body as to the allegations made, the process being followed, and those who formed the hearing panel itself. This has led to many questioning the lack of transparency, especially given the profile of both Cambage and the Opals. one of the best players in the world, and the flagship team of Australian women's basketball, was involved in an incident which ultimately resulted in her pulling out of the Opals on the eve of the Olympics. The lack of transparency in the investigation and releasing the outcome of it in a Friday afternoon news dump has only fueled rumors that Basketball Australia has swept the matter under the rug in hopes that Cambage will play for the Opals at a home World Cup in Sydney in 2022. For fans and Opal, please leave respectful comments below. Thanks so much for watching. Please like and subscribe to this channel.